All right, this is Dr. Emmanuel Amukon again. I don't know whether I should really tell you what tooth sensitivity is. Does anybody really not know what tooth sensitivity is? Okay, let's assume. Basically, tooth sensitivity is that sharp, short-lived pain that you feel. Usually, when you take something hot, cold, or sweet, and it doesn't last more than 7 minutes. As a matter of fact, it's supposed to last seconds, but maximum allowed 7 minutes. If something is not that short, then it is something else. So today we want to exhaustively talk about tooth sensitivity and its remedies. But before we go ahead, please make sure that you subscribe if you haven't subscribed. And when that bell shows up, you click on the bell so that you get notified each time we upload a new video, because more interesting videos are coming after this one. Okay, let's dive into our subject, tooth sensitivity. A majority of the people have experienced tooth sensitivity. Sometimes it is an innocent sensitivity, but sometimes you need to take it serious. Today, we are going to differentiate. So, if you have ever eaten raw mangoes, if you have bitten ice, if you have taken something so hot or so cold, you might have noticed that short-lived sharp pain. That is actually what we call tooth sensitivity. So how does tooth sensitivity come about? Basically, if you feel that pain, it means there's an area of your tooth or your teeth that has been exposed, an area which is not supposed to be exposed. Usually when your tooth is just coming out, it is covered by a layer. That layer is not sensitive to temperatures or sweet foods. But once it starts wearing off, then the sensitive part is exposed. That is the part which will cause you pain when you take hot, cold, or sweet foods. So what causes this exposure? Oh, how does it come about? There are basically many causes, but today we are going to talk about majorly 12 causes that you should be concerned about and that you can easily correct. The first one is gum recession. Gum recession means that now your gum is no longer on the gum line and it has shifted downwards. Just like the way you see in this photo, that is where the gum line is supposed to be, but you can see where it has moved to. When that happens, then that exposed area that you are seeing is the one that is going to transmit pain when you take those foods that we mentioned earlier. So how does that erosion come about? One, bad brushing. The bad brushing, we talked about it. We don't want to repeat that. And then it can also happen naturally if you have any of the following things we are going to mention. Things like gum disease. When your gums get infected, they break down. In our previous video, we talked about the causes of gum bleeding and their effects. If you haven't watched that video, please check it out and see the effects that we talked about. But yes, gum disease can lead to shift in your gum line and expose the sensitive part of your tooth. Apart from gum recession, we also have enamel erosion. That layer that we talked about, that is normally present when your tooth has just come out, it can also wear out. Number one, by natural use, depending on the diet, the action of grinding can wear out the teeth and then expose that area. But also, clenching of teeth, either due to stress or anger or anything that causes somebody to grind their teeth, can lead to wearing of the enamel and expose the sensitive part of your teeth. Then when you take those foods we talked about, you feel it as sharp pain. The other cause is people who grind their teeth in their sleep. We normally call that bruxism. Now, grinding of your teeth when you are asleep may not be exactly within your control, but actually it is also an effect of stress. But during daytime, you may not be clenching and grinding the teeth, but at night in your sleep, maybe in your dream, you close the teeth and then you start grinding them, and eventually they wear out, and the worn out teeth will look like this that you are seeing. And that yellow part you are seeing is the exposed part that will cause you pain. Then we also have cracks in the teeth. These cracks may be visible, as in this picture, or they may be invisible. If they are visible, like this one, then it is easy for you to know. But if they are not visible, it requires a special kind of examination with a special light for us to see that your tooth has cracks. So when your tooth has a crack, then that crack transmits the temperature changes in your mouth, and that's how you feel the pain as tooth sensitivity. The other cause is the infection of the sinuses. Now, sinuses are these spaces that you are seeing in this picture. You can see how they are related to the teeth, and once there is infection of that area, then it puts pressure and around the tissues that are covering the roots of the teeth, and they manifest as sensitivity. But this specific one may not be caused by temperatures only. It might just be caused by even eating something that is of regular temperature, but you'll feel it as a sharp pain. So that also is contributory to the causes of tooth sensitivity. Another thing that we should not forget about is that sometimes you can have your teeth when they are numb, and then you start biting ice or taking something very hot. Even if your teeth are normal, surely you will feel the sensitivity as a result of those extreme temperature exposures. Also, sometimes when we do dental procedures, we expect, if it is a filling, we expect that the vibration of the drill, as you are seeing in this picture, might cause disturbance within the tooth. Now, this disturbance is going to show up as sensitivity just for a few days. At most, it might last something like 5 days, but that is also to be expected. So when you experience that, that is absolutely normal. It happens to the majority of the people. But if it is any other procedure other than filling, a direct filling, sensitivity should not occur. Okay, we also have tartars. When these tartars accumulate, they have a tendency to push your gum out of position, like the way you are seeing in this video. Then, when they push your gum out of space, the area which is exposed as a result of pushing out the gum will become sensitive. And this is what you will feel as tooth sensitivity. And talking about those tartars, when you have plenty of tartars accumulated and you go for cleaning, you normally do what we call deep cleaning, or in our language, root planing. When you do that, you'll be cleaning out the tartars from below the gum, as you are seeing in this photo. And then when you do that, you expose this area which was initially pushed off by the tartars, and this area will be sensitive for some time. If it is not severe, the gum can grow back, but in severe cases, you might have to consider other solutions. And then, everybody loves white teeth, not so. Some people prefer to go for tooth bleaching. However, this tooth bleaching, as you see in this photo, we use chemicals. These chemicals actually remove a protective layer from your teeth. And by so doing, they create pores. Those pores will act as a transmission channel for the changes of temperature in your teeth. So when you go and take something, then you feel it as tooth sensitivity. But anyway, the people who do that, they are aware and they consider that a small price for beauty. So if you are one of those people who consider that a small price to pay, then well and good, you can go and do your tooth whitening. But you should know it has a consequence of tooth sensitivity. Finally, our usual suspect. And what is that? You guessed it. Tooth decay. Yes, tooth decay can also show up as a tooth sensitivity, especially in the early stages. In fact, we have this saying: if your tooth has a filling, then you should consider that it needs a filling. What that means is that there is a very high likelihood that if your tooth has fillings with double E, it has a cavity somewhere, whether you see it or not, but it could be having a cavity. And that needs to be checked and refilled accordingly. So, we have now exhausted our causes of tooth sensitivity. Now you know them. So what can you do? Solution number one: avoid extreme temperature foods. In addition to that, there are also foods that you need to avoid. In fact, these foods, if you have a sensitive tooth, you know them yourself. So if you know that this is the food or a drink that causes me sensitivity, just avoid it. The examples are here in this photo, as you can see, but the photo is not exhaustive. It is not covering all of them. This is just for an example, but avoid these ones. Also, we talked about the gum recession. I would like to just emphasize this one. Please use soft Bristol toothbrushes. Next, if you know that you have a problem of grinding your teeth at night, please consider having a night guard made for you. When you put it on, as you are seeing here, it protects the grinding of the upper and the lower teeth. In addition to that, there are also other simple but helpful solutions that have found to work. Homemade solutions. For example, clove oil. Clove oil has been found to have ingredients that enhance the health of the gums, but also it has a soothing effect. So you might also want to use it, you put it in the mouth, and then you gargle for 2 minutes and then you spit. Something else beneficial that they have found is coconut oil. Basically, it is used the same way. But for the coconut oil, you take it, you add a spoonful of salt, and then you move it around the mouth, as you are seeing in this photo, and then for 2 minutes, and then you spit it. It has the same effect as the clove oil. But if you don't have all that, just make a simple, what we call a salty water mouthwash. Basically, it's just warm water with salt, a half a tablespoonful of salt in 300 ml of water, then you boil, then you cut. Another thing that has been found to be useful is garlic. So you just make a paste like the one you are seeing here, and then you take it, then you smear it on the affected teeth. It will give you relief for the meantime as you make arrangements to visit your dentist. Now, if you have tried all that and it is not working, then you are left with one more option. And this option is visit your dentist. So what we do, when we find the cracks, we'll work on them. Or if it is completely broken like this one, then you know that this one definitely needs to be removed, and then you think about replacement options. But if it is the deep grooves, then we have what you call sealants. These sealants, we use them as you are seeing in this photo. As you are seeing the grooves of the tooth on this left side, they are black. And the other one, you see the white substance, that is a sealant that we have used to cover those deep grooves. Because those deep grooves could be a decay in progress, or they could have, it could actually be an active decay. But when you seal like that, then the sensitivity ends. Another thing we do, we can do what we call fluoride varnish. As you can see, it is a simple procedure that we do using a brush, as you are seeing, and then we just smear the fluoride the way you are seeing there. Even though some people don't like the fact that it tends to make the teeth slightly yellowish, as you are seeing, but compared to the discomfort of having sensitive teeth, it's a small price to pay. And the yellowish coloration does not stay, but then you'd have remained with the benefit of ending your tooth sensitivity. Then if it is a cavity, definitely we refill the cavity. If it is too deep, we do other procedures, and then your sensitivity will be brought to an end. Next, if you have tartars, go for scaling and polishing. Have the cleaning done, and then if the exposure is not so much, you can just use anti-sensitive toothpaste. There are toothpastes that are specifically designed with a very high content of fluoride that are very, very useful for sensitivity. So, with all this being said, you should be able to handle your tooth sensitivity now properly. And with that, I think we have answered the causes and the management of tooth sensitivity. If you have liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Sincerely, why haven't you subscribed? So make sure you subscribe so that you continue watching more of these videos. And for all your questions and comments, make sure you leave them under the comment section. fact, even this video you're watching right now is as a result of somebody's question. So please leave your questions in the comment section. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.